This morning is a Williamson turn. What a Williamson turn is and what it's used for, and the definition of a Williamson turn. All right. The Williamson turn is a maneuver used to bring a ship or boat under power back to a point it previously passed through, often for the purpose of recovering a man overboard. The Williamson turn is used if the point is still relatively near. All right. Can anyone else tell me what a Williamson turn could be used for?
Man overboard.
Okay, other than man overboard?
Lost hat.
Exactly.
Other cargo.
Awesome. Okay, pets. We've had customers who have had pets jump overboard. You're gonna have to execute a Williamson turn to go back and get your dog if it jumps overboard. Objects that blow out of the boat. I personally witnessed somebody in Norwalk Harbor, two friends of mine, she jumped off the stern of her well craft to get a $20 bill that had blown out of the back of the boat. So these are all reasons why, not something I would personally do in Norwalk Harbor, but these are all reasons, something that you would want to execute a Williamson turn. You can also, people that are tubing or water skiers. Okay, to go back and pick up a water skier, you can use a Williamson turn as well. The way to execute the Williamson turn, and the folks that have the boats on their desk, if you can follow along. Okay, the way to execute a Williamson turn is to make four 90-degree turns at a constant speed and return on a reciprocal course running back up your wake, is how it's described. Reciprocal course meaning the opposite of the way that you were heading. All right, so if you could follow along, all right, and just do four 90-degree turns. All right, you're gonna do 1, 2, 3, 4 90-degree turns. All right, that'll put you back, running back your wake in the opposite direction. As we mentioned before, if it's in response to a man overboard, you're gonna wanna execute the Williamson turn in the direction that the person fell out of the boat. So in other words, if you're traveling in this direction here, all right, and the person falls off the port side, you're going to want to make your Williamson turn to the port side. That swings the stern and the propellers and the working end of the boat away from the individual in the water. Obviously not a good combination to have your props near a person in the water. So remember, if it's a man overboard situation, you're going to want to execute and start that turn in the direction that the person fell overboard. Can anybody tell me what could be the pros and cons of a Williamson turn?
Other traffic.
Correct.
Obstructions.
Yep.
Shovel board.
The pros, I'll give you the pros, are going to be it's possible to recover a person, valuables, or other objects that have fallen in the water, as we discussed. It's a reasonably simple maneuver to complete, again, with a four 90-degree turns heading back up your wake. And it's also a reliable method for large and small vessels. You can do this on a 15-foot skiff. You can do this on a large commercial ship. All right, commercial shipping and large vessels will use a Williamson turn to go back and run a reciprocal course if they have lost a person overboard. The cons are, if you're the only person left on the helm, you may temporarily lose sight of the person in the water, okay? And that's, we're going to discuss later in the course, man overboard techniques, but one of the most important things if somebody falls out of the boat is to not lose sight of the person in the water. Now, the reason you may lose sight of the person in the water is because you're the only person at the helm now. So if somebody falls out of the boat for a few seconds, you may lose sight of them while you're executing a Williamson turn. You need to be very cautious and maintain proper speed of the boat. Obviously, we had an accident down in Greenwich, Connecticut a few years ago where there were two girls, actually there were four teenage girls that were out tubing for the afternoon. And what happened was when the girl at the helm went to go back and get the two folks in the water, she ran them over. So you had one fatality and you had one severe injury. They never released what actually happened. Did she lose sight of the people in the water, or did she simply lose control of the boat and run over her friends? But obviously you're gonna have to maintain proper control of the boat when you're executing a Williamson turn. Finally, in conclusion, the Williamson turn is an essential maneuver for recovering a man overboard who's still relatively near by turning back up your wake, and if done correctly in a man overboard situation, can be a lifesaver. Thank you.